Did you know that you can receive notifications via the Azure app, voice, email, SMS, and webhook when your services are impacted by an Azure service disruption? Duke Kamstra is here to show us how we can use Azure Monitor Action Groups to keep on top of everything happening in Azure, today on Azure Friday. Today on Azure Friday, we're going to learn all about Azure Monitor Action Groups from Duke Kamstra, Program Manager in the Azure Monitor team. So, Duke, what would you like to talk about?
Today, I'd like to demonstrate a couple of things. First of all, how we set up an action group, and then second, I want to demonstrate how we can use action groups to get notified when Azure is having an outage. It's a pretty important scenario, and we'd like everybody to be aware of that.
Okay.
Sound good?
Yes.
All right. So, here I am in the Azure portal. And I'm going to go ahead and set up an action group. The way I find the action group's user experience is I go to Monitor, so the Azure Monitor Blade, and then I choose Alerts. And then up here I have a Manage Action Groups button. So I'm going to go ahead and click that. And you can see I've been using them a lot, but I'll go ahead and create a new action group. And I need to give it a name. So let's see, we're at Channel 9 today, so I'll call it Channel 9 Demo. I will give it a short name. More on why we do that later. I created a resource group earlier for the Channel 9 demo, so I'm going to store the action group is actually an ARM resource, so I need to put it in a resource group. And now I'm going to define some actions. And these action names, these are basically my friendly reminders of what's inside the action definition. So for example, Duke's, let's see, numbers. And I will go ahead and here. And here you can see the different kinds of actions we support. So email, SMS, push notifications to the Azure app, voice, we can actually invoke an Azure function or a logic app, call your webhook, even call an ITSM, for example, ServiceNow or Provence, or execute an automation runbook. So these are all the different action types I have. I'll go ahead and set up this email push stuff, and I'll go ahead and say, hey, send me an email whenever this action is triggered. Also, we just recently released the capability to just specify an ARM group, so an ARM role. So for example, you could send this action or this notification to all the members of your Azure subscription owner role, or more interestingly, the monitoring contributor role. So that's our current recommendation is, hey, the folks that want to know about what alerts are triggering in the monitoring system, go ahead and add them to the monitor role, and here I can specify all those folks and they will all get the notification. And then what we do is look in the role, grab everybody's email addresses, and send them an email.
So okay? This itself, this is just what you want to happen if something else triggers this action.
Correct. Yeah,
okay.
What I'm saying here is when the alert that calls this action fires, send an email to all of these people.
Perfect.
Okay. We also support SMS. This is pretty popular. We've got a bunch of country codes that we support, I think 16 of them. So I could go ahead and put my phone number in here. The interesting thing about email addresses in SMS is they run on what we call dial tone. So if Azure is down, we are still able to send you an email or send an SMS to you, or for that matter, make a phone call. Whereas these other actions that take a direct dependency on Azure, if that part of Azure is down,
right. That
notification won't work.
Well, that would make a lot of sense.
Yeah.
Okay.
Azure app. I want to highlight Azure app. So if you haven't installed the Azure app, I highly recommend that you do, and you can get push notifications there. It's very popular for folks that don't want to pay for SMS. They'd rather use their data plan. And then finally, voice. Not very popular feature, honestly, because none of us like to get woken up at 2 o'clock in the morning by a voice call from Azure.
Okay.
All right. So I'll go ahead I'll turn that off. I'll go ahead and save the setting. And now I have my personal phone numbers, basically. Similarly, I could go ahead and set up a webhook. And webhooks are just HTTP endpoints. So you as the customer set up some sort of HTTP endpoint. It could be any sort of code that exposes an HTTP endpoint. And you just specify that endpoint in the action. Did I spell it right? Favorite.com. Okay, and every time this action group is called, we will send the payload to that HTTP endpoint, and then you can write code that processes that data and does the right thing.
Okay.
Okay, so there we go. We've set up a couple of actions. As I mentioned before, I can also use functions, logic apps, ITSM, and runbooks.
So more than just notifying, you can actually just go take action and tell you, by the way, I did this thing.
Exactly. So a runbook, for example, you could automatically mitigate, right?
Right.
Look at the data, say, you know what? I need to reboot that VM. So right. Go ahead and use a runbook to reboot it.
Okay.
So auto mitigation of a potential issue, right? And I want to point out that this action group, I can use it in as many alerts as I want. I don't have to go into every alert and define a new list, you know, once again, put in my email address.
Right.
Once again, put in my webhook address. This is a reusable component. So I'll go ahead and save it. And now I'm going to show you how I might use that. So I'm going to pop over to the Service Health Alerts Blade. And this is where you as the customer could come in and find out what's going on. What is Azure telling me about the availability of Azure? Could be outages, could be planned maintenance that's coming, or just information, what we call health advisories, just information you should be aware of to successfully use Azure. My favorite example is, hey, we're deprecating some SDK version.
Okay? Right.
We're going to do it in a year, but you should be aware because it may take you a while to accommodate that change. So I'm going to go ahead into health alerts, and I'm going to say create a service health alert. A service health alert is what we call the alert that is monitoring the service health communications coming from the Azure platform. So when we discover that an outage is going on that has customer impact, we will let the subscription, we will send a notification to the subscriptions that we believe are impacted.
And if you have subscribed to that as
an alert,
then you will be notified.
Okay. Via the action group, exactly. So I'm just going to make it easy here. I'm going to say, okay, all regions, all services, okay? So this is all the stuff that you might use in Azure. And there are three different forms of alert. There are service issues, AKA outages. There are planned maintenance and health advisories. So I'll just say everything. I want all of it. And then down here.
And then on planned maintenance, before you go any further, on planned maintenance, is that when they notify you that it will be happening?
Actually tell you it's coming.
Right.
Yeah.
And so you can take preventative action when you get notified.
Exactly.
Okay.
Exactly. Yeah. Yeah. So in the planned maintenance, they say this is the planned schedule for the maintenance. And then when it starts, we send another notification saying it has started.
Okay.
If we have to reschedule, we will tell you, hey, it's rescheduled or canceled.
Great. Okay.
So yeah, the planned maintenance, highly recommend that you subscribe to that. And then again, I pop over to my list of action groups and say, there's my Channel 9 demo action group. Okay, so that's what will get executed when this alert is triggered. So my service health alert, and today, and let's see. Go ahead, and I'm not going to enable it because I already have one of these, trust me. Okay, I go ahead and, I got to put it in a resource group. The alerts are resources as well, so I need to put it in a resource group. And there you go, now I have an alert. So the next time Azure sends me a notification that my subscription is being impacted by maintenance or whatever,
right.
Those actions that I define will get executed.
That's fantastic.
Okay.
Okay.
And there you go.
Is there anything more you want to show us?
No, not today. That's what I wanted to highlight. Yeah.
And where would we go to learn more?
The Azure documentation site, so azure.com, and search for service health alerts or action groups. You know, either one will pop up the documentation on configuring a service health alert or specifically configuring an action group. Any other thing? I think I've covered it all. Yeah.
Great. Thanks again. It was really great to hear all about action groups.
My pleasure. My pleasure. Happy to be here.
And we've been learning all about Azure Monitor Action Groups today on Azure Friday.